As you step out, it's not just a beautiful cool breeze, which is always looked forward to at this time of the year, that envelops us, but the warmth of glittering lights, smiling warm colorfully dressed people, and warm delicacies that we each look forward to this Diwali. It is this Diwali that we are invited to dive into and see the truth that we are not separate, that we are each an integral part of one fabric. We each are beckoned to remember our intrinsic nature of love, the joy we feel from peacefully accepting and welcoming each other with a delicious hug. We then naturally wish no harm to come to any human being. We practice ahimsa, the first of the yamas. The beautiful sturdy flame of the diya, when concentrated on, draws us to not just be mesmerized by it, but to understand the powerful similarity we hold with that flame. When we spend time in going within with pranayama and meditation, we align our thoughts, actions and speech. We align the energies of each cell that constitute us in harmony to bring about being in truth. We fearlessly, truthfully be. We practice satya, the second of the yamas. It is on Diwali we wish to nourish and intrinsically wish to be a part of the abundance of life and joy around us. We wish to dress up in bright and warm colors and enjoy the beautiful radiance of others. We let our own joy spill out as we immerse in the joy of others. We don't wish to steal from ourselves or downplay or belittle ourselves or anyone else. The beautiful spirit feels no need to steal. We practice asteya, the third of the yamas. We see the bright flames not only in the diyas but in each and every one of us. With the practice of yoga, pranayama and meditation, we know these colors, the exciting experience and ever-flowing energy is not just outside but within. We are implored, begged to come home this Diwali to ourselves, minus the thoughts, the ego, the body, to a pure boundless energy within, to come face to face with the experience of Brahmacharya, which means the experience of being established in divine consciousness, the fourth of the yamas. This festival, there is a joy in sharing and spreading mirth and laughter, even while buying the diyas and paying the vendor a little extra. We are ready to let go of grievances, experiencing an infectious sense of abundance and overflowing. We feel no need to hoard or to hold on to neither things or hurts or a score of wrongdoings or even thoughts. We practice aparigraha, the fifth of the yamas. We are unintentionally practicing the first limb of the eight limbs of yoga every Diwali. Let's pause and let the practice deepen all year, starting this Diwali. Wishing you a happy, a very happy Diwali.